we have a new set of requirements, and this would be actually 100% observed if we will be allowed to continue with the e-games and the e-bingo. When we investigated, like, we found that 32% of them are in violation of distance requirements. Currently, it's 200 meters radius.
Would you extend that or just enforce it strictly?
We're looking into a 500 meter radius, but we're looking at it from a point of view also of feasibility. Baka naman kung masyadong nasa labas, wala. But we are going to insist that there won't be standalone stations. They have to be in 3-star hotels, in malls, and in arcades.
Ma'am, could you talk about the plan to offload the commercial operations of PAGCOR?
It's a difficult process because, one, PAGCOR's original charter is really to own and regulate gambling by itself. And then in 2007, there was an additional function that was put in when the PAGCOR life was renewed, no? Yeah. And it says that it can now license and therefore would have to regulate licensees. So nagkaroon ng dual role, regulatory as well as owning and managing all their own operations. Now, there are 46 casinos from medium size to small one. And there are casinos that are fully owned by us, therefore 100%. And there are casinos where there's a sharing, 65, 40, like that. So this one, each of them have to be treated differently. So we're looking into all of that. So the first thing to do is to make a complete profile, a complete write-up on all of the 46, including what their incomes have been for the last, from the first time that they were created or opened up. And then make a projection of what their incomes are for the next 10 years. Because as I said, these are not dead assets. They are profitable assets except for one small one, which is in Tagum. So the way I see it, my role is to be as accurate as I can on the profiles and on the financials of each of the 46. And then, so then when we submit it to finance, then they know what the problems would be in or how they're going to do.
How about, ma'am, talk about the plans or proposals to merge with PCSO?
It would be difficult. It is logical in a sense that it's all gaming. So putting it in one organization with a reasonable organizational and functional structure and with competent people, it can be done. However, there's a lot of sensitivities because PCSO and PAGCOR, they cater to different games, different markets. There's also probably a very strong sense of territoriality because PCSO has been there forever. So I do not know how that can be done.
How do you see this industry developing with all these challenges unfolding? How do you see this industry years from now?
I am challenged by the fact that I really want to be, at least to remain, one of the three top revenue earners of the country. We're now third, next to customs. And if I get the same trust that I have now from the office of the president and would allow us to regulate and allow us to offer new products, I intend to double our revenue by the end of my term, which is 100 billion.
How do you intend to do that, ma'am?
New games, new products, strict regulation, making sure that you are able to get every single centavo due the government from all of your licenses and from all of the casinos that you operate. Plug all loopholes and leakages and contain marketing costs.